Hello everyone, how are you? Today we're gonna make this 3D Easter egg in Blender. Okay, let's begin. First, let's add a sphere, scale it down a bit, and in edit mode, in vertex selection mode, let's select this top middle vertex, enable proportional editing, and move on the Z axis. Increase or decrease the influence using the mouse wheel or the page up and page down keys. Let's add a subdivision modifier and shade a smooth. Let's scale a bit and back to edit mode. Let's move up a bit more. And let's scale on the X axis just a bit. And now select the bottom middle vertex and move on the Z axis. Let's scale a bit. Select the camera and now choose the view you like and press Ctrl+Alt+0 to place the camera. Let's move it a bit and I want a square resolution. I'm also gonna change the focal length. I want a longer focal length. Let's make the material. I'm gonna use this default material and I'm also gonna add a second material for the outline. Change it to emission. And let's choose the color. I went for a dark purple bluish color. And enable back face scaling. Now let's add a solidify modifier. Change the material offset to 1. Enable even thickness and enable flip normals. Change the offset to 0 and choose the thickness you like. Let's change to material preview mode so we can see the outline, and here it is. Now let's make the material for the egg. Let's go to camera view and I'm gonna show you two ways of making a stripe material. So for the first one, let's add a wave texture node and a mapping and a texture coordinate node. And of course we need a color ramp node for the colors. Change it to constant. And let's move this one and let's rotate the stripes. And you can make them thinner or thicker. And you can also change the scale if you want less stripes. I'm gonna choose the colors, just choose whatever you like. And this is a way of having simple stripes. You can look for videos about how to make different procedural patterns. But to make the same material as I did, we can actually delete the wave texture node. Let's move the color stop until you see both colors, and you can also change the scale. And let's move up a bit. I'm gonna plug the texture coordinate from the window output just to see the materials a bit better. Okay, now we can add another color stop. I chose the same pink color. And let's try to make the stripes more straight. And now add another color stop, and this time it's gonna be a white color. And let's add another color stop, and this time it's gonna be this light blue color. Let's move the stripes down and let's just move the color stops Then I connected the texture coordinate using the UV output to get this spherical effect on the lines. They were straight before, and now they are following the shape of the mesh. Okay, now we can add a tone kind of shadow on the side, and for that we're gonna make the typical tone material. We just need a diffuse BSDF, a shader to RGB, a color wrap node, and a texture coordinate and a mapping node. Select the color ramp and press Shift Control so we can preview this group of nodes we have here. Change to constant and let's move it. Now let's set up the lighting. So enable scene and world lights and change the default light to a sun and rotate it until you like the placement of the shadow. You can enable high bit depth shadow to reduce some artifacts. And to connect both groups of nodes, just add a mix node. Connect both color ramps. And remember to change your mix node to color. And take the factor to 1 and change the blending mode to multiply. And now change this black color to a lighter color. You could add a bit of blue or purple to this color as well. Later on the video, I will change this shadow color a bit and disable the shadow in the light object. Let's change the color a bit. Let's scale it and move it a bit. And I decided to change the color management to a standard and to medium low contrast, but while I was finishing the project, I decided to change the look to just medium contrast. Okay, now add a grease pencil object. Remember to be in frame 1 before adding it. And disable use lights. First, we're gonna make the eyes, and for the eyes, I'm gonna use the same color I used for the outline. So let's go to this material and you can just copy and paste the color code. And I want the same color for the fill. Take the alpha to 1 and now let's go to draw mode. I'm gonna use the circle tool and I'm gonna draw on the surface. Take the strength to 1 and let's disable use pressure for both the strength and the radius. We're gonna draw in camera view mode. Every time we draw, remember to be in camera view mode. And let's just make a circle. You can press Shift to make a perfect circle. And this is pretty close to the mesh, so it's okay. And now let's draw another one. Okay, now in edit mode, select a circle and go to stroke selection mode. And we can make it a bit smaller and move it a little bit if you want to. And back to draw mode, let's draw the mouth. We're gonna use the arc tool to make the mouth. Let's take this default material. We're gonna use the same color, but this time it has to be only a stroke material without the fill. And change the line type to line. Press M to flip the arc and Shift to make a perfect arc. And you can release your mouse and you can tweak the shape using the manipulator. Confirm with the middle mouse button or the return key. Or you can do what I did, which is first I made the arc and then I went to sculpt mode, and using the push brush you can tweak the shape. Later on the video I tweaked the shape a bit more. And you can smooth the arc and the circles a bit. And in edit mode, let's move it up a little bit. Let's see how it looks. And back to draw mode, now we're gonna draw the eyes highlights. So we need a new material. This time is going to be a white material. And we need a new layer. Remember to be in frame 1 before adding a new layer. And place it on top of the face layer. This time we're gonna change the stroke placement to a stroke. And we're gonna use the draw tool. Let's make the radius a bit bigger and let's make 2 dots. Now let's make the radius a bit smaller and let's draw 2 dots on each side. And again, make the radius a bit smaller and draw 2 dots here and 2 dots here. Make the radius a bit smaller and draw this on each side. Now let's also draw the highlights on the egg. We need a new layer for that. And change the stroke placement to surface again. Let's make the radius a bit bigger. And here I pressed shift while making the strokes to get a bit of a more stable stroke. And let's change this white color a bit. And in a sculpt mode we can smooth the lines a bit. Let's lock the face layer since we don't want to touch that one. And let's make some changes. Let's move the mouth a bit again. And let's also change the placement of the stripes a bit. I want them to be a bit lower. And now let's go back to the grease pencil object and add a noise modifier to make the highlights twinkle a bit. Choose the eyes highlight and take the position to 0, and you can play with the other settings. You could also make the eyes blink. I have a video for that. Just look for the blinking eyes chapter, link in the description and at the end of the video. In edit mode, let's move this stroke a bit. And back to sculpt mode, let's tweak the mouth a bit. And let's smooth it. And in a new layer, we could also add some stars. Let's make a new material. I'm gonna use this color again. And for the fill, I'm gonna use a yellow color. Let's change the stroke placement to 3D cursor this time. and let's draw these diamond stars. And for these stars, we can use a noise modifier as well, so duplicate the one we already have, but change the layer. Let's decrease the strength, and in this case, I think that we can use the position and it will look nice. Let's move these two stars a bit. And for the background, you can go watch this video right here. The very first chapter teaches you how to make this kind of gradient background. It's very simple to make. As you can see, I played with the scale to get a similar shape as the egg, and I used a blue and a white color. Remember before rendering to enable set passes. And that's it for today's video. If you want to add a blink animation and a gradient background to this model we made today, you can go watch these two videos. And if you made it this far, thanks for watching and see you in the next one. Bye!